Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. If you guys have a BMW 3 Series, I'm talking about generation 2005 to 2013. This one will cover E90, E91, 92, 93 guys. And you have guys code 2E94 or any of the following guys for codes 2E94, 2AD0, 5187, which could be actually called P1717 depending which scanner you use. Save this and we'll explain guys how to fix that and what causes that. Now it will take quite a bit of work guys. Make sure you stay until the end and we'll show you guys one simple part that causes all that and your car to malfunction guys. You may notice hard start, transmission not working correctly, slipping, not having enough power. All these guys will be present, so we'll be covering how to do that today. Before we start, every single car we get at the shop, we make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos guys. And why we do all that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video guys so we can keep providing that free information. Now if you need to buy replacement parts or tools needed to fix that code guys, check out the links in the description of the video below. We share everything for your convenience. So now we have a 6-cylinder engine, but even if you have a different engine guys, a 4-cylinder engine, for instance in Europe, in the US here, that generation didn't make it with a 4-cylinder engine, or if you have a diesel engine, the procedure will be practically the same guys and we'll explain how to do that. Before we start, let me show you guys how hard the car starts. So listen now, I will shut up for a little bit so you can see and hear yourself, and you will notice the transmission light will be on. So the RPMs will keep going up and down, car will be super unstable. What we'll be doing now, we'll turn the ignition switch on. Where the lights are on, the car is not running guys, check it out now. Okay, perfect, just like that, this is it. We have the scanner here connected to the OBD port of the vehicle, just plug it in. Now, this scanner guys, it's something I'll definitely recommend. If you're on the market for a good scanner, definitely guys, worth the investment in my opinion. This is amazing too guys, it works on any car, not just BMW. Check out all the vehicles that it supports now. You can even work on Audi, Bentley, BMWs, Ferraris, Lamborghinis. It's amazing too guys, and we have been using it extensively for the last 2.5 years. Never had any problem with it. So we click VIN, auto detect. We will share the link in the description of the video below. Okay, it's loading now. It's going to take just a little bit of time because it can access, read and delete codes and see live data for every module, every computer in your car. We select BMW European. It's going to read the VIN number and we need to confirm that this is the correct one in a second. All right. And now we click yes. This is the correct vehicle that we have, E91 325 XI N52 engine guys. So now right here guys, we're going to click diagnostics. We can go to auto scan and scan the whole system, or you can select control unit and select individual computers. We have the drive here, you will find the engine computer, transmission, chassis will be usually ABS, traction control and other things on the chassis, and this is the body. You can see you can access every computer in your car. So what I'll go under drive, engine computer, we'll select here, read codes, perfect. And the codes that we have guys, okay, check it out now, 2A94 and code 2AD0. Now if I go back to transmission, you will have another code that's related to the 2AD0 guys, and that code will be 5187. No message receiver from EGS, the transmission control module pretty much. So now that's a problem guys, right here. Now what causes that problem? Pretty simple guys, stay with us, we'll start taking things apart and show you how to fix it. But you will always guys have, okay, if that's a problem, you always have that code 2A94, okay, which means that you have problems with the crankshaft sensor or signal. So let's continue now. So if you guys have that 6-cylinder engine guys, and as I said, we're demonstrating on N52 engine, you will have to guys remove your intake manifold to get to the what is causing guys these codes. Okay, and that code that we were talking about, 2E94 guys, this is code related to the crankshaft position sensor. In order to get to it, guys, you will need to remove the intake manifold. Now, for any of you that wonder how to do that, okay, I don't want to waste your time. We have the complete video on the channel, and I'll try to put the link in the description of the video below. If you don't find it there for some reason, check it out. We have it on the channel, how to remove intake manifold on BMW N52 engine. N52, guys, you will find it out. Tips that we are going to share, guys, common problems and common mistakes people make when working on it. Always put in new intake manifold gasket. Mistake number one, people do not disconnect the car battery when you start working on the vehicle. You're going to be super close to the battery, positive wire to the engine starter, alternator. You guys have leaking fuel from the fuel line here on top. Okay, that's a fuel line, because you have to disconnect it. Okay, and if you touch this one, spark somewhere on the ground, you can, guys, catch your car on fire. You can burn electronics because you didn't disconnect your car battery. You can cause multiple electrical damages to your vehicle, guys. Number two, it really matters on modern vehicles which battery terminal you disconnect and reconnect first, positive or negative. For any of you that don't know that, we have the video on the channel, which battery terminal to disconnect first. Check it out, guys. Super important information, and I'll try to put the link in the description of the video below as well. So once all that being done, guys, okay, let me explain what we have here, guys. Right under the engine starter, guys, right under your engine starter, we have one wire. This wire leads to the crankshaft position sensor. This wire, if it's loose, you're going to have those signs. Your car will not be starting good. You will get that code 2E94 and the other codes as a result of that as well, guys. So it could be just a loose wire. If it's not a loose wire, but make sure it's not broken somewhere as well, you need to put a new sensor, crankshaft position sensor. You will have to clean all the dirt here. If you have dirt and dust, vacuum it. Okay, because if you remove that sensor and you did not clean the dirt, everything will fall back in the engine, the open, and that can cause, okay, damage to your engine, guys. So we're going to need a reverse torque socket. We'll share the links for all the tools and parts that we use in the description of the video below, guys. Check it out. And we're going to remove that sensor. This is the crankshaft position sensor, guys. So number one reason, check the wire. Number two, it could be a bad sensor. Again, make sure your car battery is disconnected, guys, when you do that. So let's go ahead, do that now. Okay, let me see if we can get it out. Perfect, this is the bolt right there. Okay, that's what the bolt looks like. Let me leave it so I don't drop it. Now grab the sensor, shake it a little bit. It may be stuck. You might need to use a little bit of a screwdriver to pry it out. Okay, it comes out. There is an O-ring that gets stuck there, guys. And this is the crankshaft position sensor that's causing that trouble, guys. Okay, right there. This is it. This is the device, guys. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you having these codes. That definitely fixes our problem. Most of the times we get that at the shop, check the wiring harness, check the sensor itself. We will even have a video on the channel how to test the sensor coming soon. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching, and see you guys next time.